Warning, the following video contains material unsuitable for children. If you're a kid under the age of 13, click off this video now and go watch something else. Viewer discretion is advised.
One day, Ernest the engine car and Stevie the steam train noticed Gail the guards compartment looking particularly broody, even by her usually militant feminist standards. What's on your mind? Ernest ventured, in the mood for a bit of lezzo baiting.
I'm trying to decide on a pet, said Gail. What I really want is a baby, she admitted. But I can't conceive.
Stevie the steam train decided to contribute.
What you need is a big black cock, a big black cock, a big black cock, a big black cocker spaniel, he said,
as usual stuttering badly at the most inappropriate of moments.
Or if you can't accommodate a big black cock, a big black cock, a big black cocker spaniel, how about a small white cock, a small white cock, a small white cocker too? Mind you, I've gone off feathered, friends,
he continued. Unwisely.
Ever since I was on the internet and I saw a bird with a mouth full of cock, a mouth full of cock, a mouth full of cockroaches.
By now, Gail was feeling a little ill.
Perhaps you could suggest a bird without cock in it?
That rules out Paris Hilton, quipped Ernest, hoping for a spot on the glass house, or failing that, spicks and specks.
How about an even smaller yellow cock, an even smaller yellow cockatiel,
continued Stevie.
That's hardly a bird at all.
Forget it,
said Gail.
I think I'll just adopt.
Gail, the guards compartment, wasn't happy. While she'd been out, Ernest the engine car had somehow put up a poster on the shed, despite having no arms. It was a poster of Tammy the Tangara, and she was topless.
This is sexual harassment,
complained Gail. Lighten up, said Ernest.
Yeah,
said Stevie, who was reading Asian Trains and waiting for a gust of wind to turn the page.
I suppose the shunt is out of the question.
That's it,
snapped Gail.
I'm making a complaint to the Sexual Harassment Board.
Knock it off, said Ernest. Anyone can see you're gagging for it.
I am not.
Well, then how come you're always rolling around in front of us all day naked, said Ernest. If you're not that kind of carriage, you'd put some clothes on. Gail responded calmly.
Have you recently been in a woman's boutique? They never have anything over a size 14, and I'm a size 408.
Blimey, said Ernest. You should think about cutting back on cake.
I don't eat cake,
said Gail.
I don't eat anything.
Suck my cockaleaky,
offered Stevie, who had stuttered badly at the most inappropriate of moments. Cockaleaky, a Scottish dish of chicken broth with leeks, was a personal favorite, and he had some in his shed.
If you suck it through a straw, it fills you up nicely. You'll drop 400 dress sizes before you know it.
Why should I have to conform to male ideas about what a woman's appearance should be? This sort of abuse is exactly the reason for this weekend's Reclaim the Rails Women's Rights Parade.
I'd like to come on your ticker tape parade,
said Stevie supportively.
It's just a parade. There's no ticker tape. And you can't. You're a man.
That's sexual discrimination, said Ernest.
Okay, then. I'd welcome the support, but you have to look like women, which means you have to fit into a size 14 dress.
Then we'd better start sucking cock-a-leaky through a straw right away.
Ernest the engine car had finally cracked.
Get out of the f***ing way,
he said to no one in particular.
F***ing move it. Get off the f***ing road. Ernest,
said Stevie the steam train.
Are you all right? I'm fine, said Ernest. I'm just practicing my road rage. I'm fed up with public transport. I'm always late, so I'm getting a car. with a big booming stereo and a number plate that says CHXDGGT.
Wanker, 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 wanker. When cars break down, they're very expensive to fix,
said Stevie, who always stuttered badly at inappropriate moments.
And how will you even fit in a car?
I'll get the biggest four-wheel drive I can find, said Ernest.
Oh, so you're planning on being a cunt, being a cunt, being a cunt, being a country driver,
said Stevie, his stutter not getting any better.
Oh, no, said Ernest. I'll just be driving it round the city.
Oh,
said Stevie.
So you'll just be looking like a cunt, looking like a cunt, looking like a country driver, and driving like a cunt, driving like a cunt, driving like a country driver, and parking like a cunt, parking like a cunt, parking like a country driver. And everyone else who sees you will think there's a real cunt, there's a real cunt, there's a real country driving experience that he's missing out on.
I don't care what anyone else thinks, said Ernest.
Then a four-wheel drive is perfect,
said Stevie.
But aren't you worried about being stuck in traffic?
Not at all, said Ernest. I'll be using the bus lane.
Masturbation.
One day, Stevie the steam train and Gail the guards compartment were looking very pleased with themselves.
You two are looking very pleased with yourselves,
commented Ernest unnecessarily.
We're going on It Takes Two,
said Stevie.
And we're going to win it,
added Gail.
We've been practicing all day.
Well, with a whole day's practice, you're bound to win it,
said Ernest, entirely unfamiliar with the show of which they spoke, but nonetheless uncannily close to the mark.
We're just not quite sure which song to perform,
said Gail.
Mind if we try some on you?
I'm all ears,
said Ernest, which was odd, since he didn't have any ears at all.
Well, life on the farm is kinda laid back,
sang Gail.
Ain't much an old cunt, an old cunt, an old cunt, an old cunt, an old country boy like me can't hack,
sang Stevie, who always stuttered badly at the most inappropriate of moments.
It's early to rise, early in the sack,
sang Gail.
Thank God I'm a cunt, I'm a cunt, I'm a cunt, I'm a cunt, thank God I'm a country boy,
finished Stevie, his stutter not getting any better.
Right, perhaps not that one,
said Ernest.
What about another John Denver song then,
said Gail.
Take me home,
she sang.
Cunt, 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 country roads,
sang Stevie.
To the place,
sang Gail.
I belong,
sang Stevie.
West Virginia,
sang Gail.
Mountain Mama,
sang Stevie.
Take me home,
sang Gail.
Cunt, 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 country roads,
Stevie struggled.
Perfect,
said Ernest, hoping very much they'd decide to go on Dancing on Ice instead.
It was just another day in the train yard, except that Ernest the engine car had been in the maintenance shed all morning sniffing paint fumes, and by any definition was completely off his tits.
Gail, the guards compartment, could see the problem required a delicate approach.
Hey, you bloody fumehead,
she said.
You have a sniffing problem.
I do not, said Ernest, before passing out.
It's obvious, isn't it, Stevie?
Said Gail. But Stevie the steam train had a funny look in his eyes. Gail sniffed.
Have you been smoking something other than coal?
She asked.
No,
lied Stevie.
I'm disappointed in you,
said Gail.
Ernest is a young and impressionable engine.
Ernest is a dick, is a dick, is a dick, is a dick, is addicted, all right,
said Stevie, because he often stuttered badly at inappropriate moments.
But you're a bitch, you're a bitch, you're a bitch, you're a bit cheeky lecturing us on drugs,
he added.
The federal police once found you packed with high-grade heroin.
I've steered clear of drugs since then,
Gail insisted.
I even formed a support group, Carriages United Not Taking Substances. Though, for obvious reasons, we rarely use our acronym.
Well, back off anyway, narc, said Ernest.
We don't need someone ruining our high.
But it was too late for that. For all the platform speakers had started pulsing with the sounds of doof-doof music.
Oh, no, said Ernest. The big controller's on ecstasy again.
Ernest the engine car was looking glum. What's up? Said Stevie the steam train. I've had a complaint, said Ernest. A complaint? From who? Said Stevie. The fat controller, said Ernest. What's the fat controller complaining about this time? Asked Stevie, who stuttered badly at the most inappropriate of moments. Being called the fat controller, said Ernest. We can't call the fat controller anymore, said Stevie, whose stutter seemed to be getting worse. No, said Ernest. Then what are we supposed to call the fat controller? Asked Stevie. The big controller, said Ernest. We're supposed to call the fat controller a big controller, said Stevie. Yes, replied Ernest. Oh, said Stevie. I feel like a right shunt. Ernest the engine car and Stevie the steam train were looking very contented. They'd been pulling all day, and the overweight controller had been watching and liked what he'd seen.
Excuse me,
Gail butted in, as women always do.
Why is it that all the engines are men and all the carriages are women?
What are you talking about? Asked Ernest.
Everyone here that can pull things or get things done is a man. There's Ernest the engine car, Stevie the steam train, the overweight controller, even the narrator.
Complained Gail.
What's a narrator?
Asked Stevie. I'm not sure, said Ernest, but everything's just as it should be. Women at the back.
It's yet another example of sexist British children's literature,
sulked Gail.
Wind in the Willows, Peter Pan, Lord of the Rings, the list goes on.
The bitch goes on, thought Ernest.
Get a count to British literature's flawed,
said Stevie, who always stuttered badly at inappropriate moments.
Alice in Wonderland was written by a man,
he pointed out.
And he was off his tits on drugs,
rebutted Gail. Tits, thought Ernest.
And another thing, why can't something miserable be named after men? If we can have Cyclone Tracy, then we should have Cancer Tim,
ranted Gail, now clearly turning into some sort of hairy-pitted lesbian.
Oh, great, now the narrator's taking sides,
diked Gail.
What's a narrator?
Asked Stevie. I'm not sure, said Ernest. But I think that he's even more powerful than the overweight controller. I bet if he said,
And with that, the whiny Lezzo bitch shunted off back to whiny Lezzo town where she belonged. The whiny Lezzo bitch would shunt off back to whiny Lezzo town where she belongs. And with that, the whiny Lezzo bitch shunted off back to whiny Lezzo town where clearly she belonged. And the male engines laughed and wished they had arms so they could drink beer and turn on a telly to watch football and masturbate. Ernest the engine car and Stevie the steam train were about to tuck in for a long night's sleep. "Stevie," said Ernest, "do you know much about dreams? Because I keep having dreams about trains and tunnels." "Oh," said Stevie, "you know what that means." "What?" asked Ernest. "You're a bleeding train," said Stevie.
For conscious thought, dreams have literal representations," said Stevie,
who stuttered badly at the most inappropriate of moments.
"Whereas matters occupying the subconscious mind have direct, but sometimes not entirely obvious, parallels,"
he continued, clearly knowing a lot more than he'd first let on.
"They're the classic subconscious symbol of a male-to-female train coupling,"
added Stevie.
"They're not the only one, though. Anything connected with coupling. Screwing light bulbs and light fittings are another."
"What if I dream about caps on bottles?" asked Ernest.
"That's about coupling,"
confirmed Stevie. "Lampshades and lamps?" Ernest queried.
"That's about coupling,"
responded Stevie.
"Okay,"
said Ernest.
"What about a mouth covering an erect human penis?"
"Oh," said Stevie. "Buggered if I know what that's about."
Ernest the engine car and Stevie the steam train had been speculating about Gale the guards compartment all afternoon. "Gale," said Ernest, "how many routes have you had?"
"I beg your pardon,"
said Gale.
"You heard," said Stevie. "How many routes have you had?"
"I don't see how it's any of your business,"
said Gale, avoiding the question.
"More or less than 5, persisted Ernest.
"It's all very well for you engines,"
said Gale.
"You get to brag about all the routes you've had, but when you take us guards compartments out, you always expect us to have had no routes at all."
"So you admit you're a hoe, you're a hoe, you're a hoe, you're a hopeless idealist,"
said Stevie, who would always stutter badly at the most inappropriate of moments.
"You should hook up with Carrie the Courage,"
he added.
She's a tart, she's at art school, so she's a progressive thinker too."
"A guards compartment is hers to do with as she pleases,"
said Gale.
"So then, how would you feel about a 3-car train with Ernest and me, if you know what I mean?"
"Not if you were the last train on Earth,"
said Gale with finality.
"Less than 5? Asked Ernest.
"Less than 5, agreed Stevie.
It was a day much like any other day in the rail yard.
"Nazi," said Ernest.
"What?"
said Stevie.
"I know your little secret," said Ernest.
"I'm afraid you've lost me there,"
said Stevie. Between 1939 and 1945, you were involved in the transportation of tens of thousands of Jews to concentration camps, said Ernest.
What?
Said Stevie, with more than a hint of alarm. You're a Nazi war criminal, Ernest spelled out. I saw you in a photo in the Jewish Museum. Stevie was stunned. They had a photo of one of the steam engines involved in Hitler's final solution, and you're the puffing image.
I'm afraid you're gravely mistaken, said Stevie. I haven't been involved in the execution of anybody.
Ernest wasn't buying it. The jig's up, Stevie. Or should I call you Stefan, the notorious Todesspielzeug Eisenbahn?
Todesspielzeug Eisenbahn?
Said Stevie, just a little too well. Train of death, translated Ernest, as if you didn't know.
Did you see when I was flipping well built?
Asked Stevie, who always stuttered at the most inappropriate of moments.
If you check my engine block, you'll find I was assembled in 1947, a good 2 years after the fall of Berlin.
Then answer me this truthfully, replied Ernest. Have you or have you not transported thousands of people to a hostile, gloomy confinement, where they become nothing more than a number and on a daily basis have their spirits crushed and suffer humiliation and loss of self-identity until they die?
Of course I have, said Stevie cheerily. I'm a city rail commuter train.
Well then, I rest my case.